say the word Bali, and the first thing everyone thinks of is sand, surf, and fun, not snakes. But Bali's tropical climate is perfect for reptiles, and it's home to more than 38 species of snakes, a number of which are highly venomous. Because of its growing popularity as a tourist destination, there's a whole lot of building going on around the island. Paving paradise means less space for snakes and a much bigger chance of finding one in your new shower. Shinto Kikon founded the Bali Reptile Rescue Service about 4 years ago, and she and her team are the people to call when there's a reptile emergency. Shinto and expat volunteer Peter Nicholson are responding to a call from a family home in the Kangu region of the island.
Okay, don't hurt the snake. Come on, Bubby, come on. Come to Daddy, come on, over the stick, over the stick, over the stick. Let's hold him under there.
It's a spitting cobra, a common resident. At about 60 centimeters, this one's quite young and small, but its venom is still enough to cause serious injury to people and pets. Spitting cobras have specially modified fangs with small holes in them. The venom can be ejected with a velocity equivalent to that of a water pistol and can travel 4 to 8 feet, depending on the size of the snake. Spitting is strictly a defense mechanism, and these snakes are not likely to attack unless they're provoked or frightened. The snakes are active this time of year, so it's not long before Shinta gets another call from a concerned household. This time, it's a pit viper. They're not huge snakes, they grow to about 40 inches, but they're quite aggressive. Pit vipers are also common in Southeast Asia. They're highly specialized hunters with pit organs to sense temperature changes in their potential prey. These organs are so sensitive that they can detect a temperature change of less than 0.2 degrees warmer than the background, and they're incredibly accurate when striking. They're also venomous, but this one is bagged safely by Shinta and the team. The two snakes rescued this evening found their way naturally into the residential homes, but sometimes the reason is far more sinister: the pet trade.
We get a few more that are left in hotels. People come and stay in Bali for a month, so they go to the markets, buy something, and then leave it sitting in the hotel.
Wow.
And the hotel rings up and says, we've got a snake, we've got a turtle, we've got a monkey.
Yeah. So, a monkey?
Oh, yeah. Well, a monkey at the markets will cost about $40.
And how much, like, for example, if, like, one of the more exotic snakes, for example, how much would that cost at a market here?
When you get into things like corn snakes, king snakes, they're around $100.
Okay.
But a retic like this one, about $10.
$10?
Yeah.
And that's a beautiful big snake.
Oh, it's a lovely snake.
Yeah.
The captured snakes are on their way to be released. Fortunately, there are still a few wild places on Bali that are free of humans. The snakes should be safe here, amongst the tall grasses and bamboo. Great habitat for these particular species of snake.
Tonight for a pied piper and then one
bungarus, kalidas, right, and two spitting cobra.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so the first ones are the, which one are these?
Piper.
This one, the right.
Drumerosaurus insularis, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, with your brother. All right, yeah.
Snakes are a vital part of the island's ecosystem and deserve as much protection as all other species. But as Bali's infrastructure expands and the snakes have less and less space to live, there's bound to be more encounters with humans. But thanks to the work of the Bali Reptile Rescue, at least some of the snakes get a second chance at survival.